a 42-year-old male presented with fever, cough, shortness of breath and fatigue for 2 days. On examination, he had decreased oxygen saturation. The symptoms are suspicious for COVID-19 infection. Is imaging required in this case, or is only RT-PCR sufficient for diagnosis and further management of the patient? And if imaging is required, what would be the imaging findings? Hello everyone, welcome to Radio Clinics, and today's topic is imaging of COVID-19. When is imaging recommended? Flissner Society is a multidisciplinary society in thoracic radiology, and CDC, which is a Center for Disease Control and Prevention. They have established a consensus statement against the use of imaging in patients with suspected COVID-19 and mild symptoms. However, imaging can be used as diagnostic modality in the following situations: when there is concern for disease progression and when there is worsening of respiratory status in known COVID-19 cases. This has also been supported by WHO, which suggests that in addition to clinical and lab parameters, imaging is required to decide on whether the patient needs ward admission or ICU admission, and also to help in therapeutic management. Imaging is also required in resource-constrained areas. These areas are those areas where RT-PCR is not available, or RT-PCR is available but results are delayed, so that imaging helps in guiding for further management of the patient. Imaging can't be considered a gold standard test because its sensitivity is variable and reaches up to 97%, while its specificity is low, and imaging findings of COVID-19 may also be seen in other viral pneumonias and organizing pneumonias. Chest X-ray is said to be less sensitive than CT imaging. The findings in chest X-ray are the presence of bilateral, patchy, peripherally based consolidations and haziness. So in this chest X-ray, we can see there are presence of multiple bilateral hazy opacities in both the lungs. These opacities are peripheral in distribution and have lower zone predominance. In CT imaging, the imaging findings depend upon the day of exposure and upon the severity. In 0 to 4 days, the imaging findings consist of bilateral, peripheral, ground glass opacities. First, we need to know what a ground glass opacity is. A ground glass window is commonly seen as a bathroom window. We can't look through the window, light can pass through. Similarly, ground glass opacities are those opacities which are hazy, less dense, and we can see vessels pass through the opacities. So these linear branching structures within the opacity are vessels, and these opacities are ground glass in appearance. They are bilateral, peripherally based, and predominantly located in the lower lobes. Sometimes we may see circular opacities associated with ground glass opacities. These circular opacities give the appearance of an atoll. An atoll is an island consisting of circular area of land. This is a Maldivian atoll, and the opacity resembles the atoll. And sometimes we may have crazy paving opacities. It looks like pavement of the street. In crazy paving opacity, we can see ground glass opacities which are overlapped with linear thickened septa, giving pavement like appearance. These opacities are usually seen in 5 to 8 days. In 10 to 13 days of infection, the opacities are predominantly consolidations, which are also peripheral, patchy, bilateral, and are located in the lung bases. So these are consolidations, and they are different from ground glass opacities. This opacity located anteriorly in the right middle lobe is a ground glass opacity in which vessels can be seen passing through, while this opacity in the posterior aspect of the right lower lobe is a consolidation. We can't see vessels passing through the opacity. We may also encounter effusion in 7% of cases. Pneumothorax, nodules, lobar pneumonia, lymphadenopathy and cavities are not commonly encountered in COVID-19 cases, and when you see these findings, we should look for alternate diagnosis. So coming to our question, in this 42-year-old male who presented with symptoms typical for COVID-19, the first question is imaging required? I would say imaging is required because there is decreased saturation, which is a moderate feature of COVID-19, and imaging will help in guiding for further management of the patient. In the patient CT scan, we can see presence of peripherally based ground glass opacities in both the lungs, and we can see that the opacities are predominantly located in the lower lobes, which are consistent for COVID-19 infection. So the final words in this discussion are: imaging should be done in case of moderate to severe cases and in resource constrained areas. The main findings in COVID-19 in imaging are peripherally based ground glass opacities and consolidations with lower lobe predominance. Thank you.